Yo guys, what's up? It's Warspirit, and today I'm bringing you guys some more Crysis 3. This video here is going to be about what I believe are the best 5 custom classes in Crysis 3. Now, since Crytek have said that there are going to be no more patches for the game, this is basically the last stage of balance that the game is in. So, in my opinion, these here are the best 5 classes. And they're not like super overpowered or anything, they're still very fun to use. I think they're also the best, or the 5 most fun classes to use as well. So check them out guys, and try them out as well if you haven't tried them before. I hope you enjoy the video. These aren't going to be ordered in any particular way, they're just what I believe to be the 5 best. Jumping straight in guys, we're going to start off with the Grendel. So over the past few patches, the Grendel has become a little bit more mainstream than it's used to. This is mainly because of a lot of nerfs for the other weapons, and the Grendel's only had one buff, which was in the early stages of the game's release. I have been using the Grendel since release because I knew it was going to get buffed, and basically once you get good with a weapon which is pretty weak and then it gets buffed, then you can pretty much start killing everyone really easily. The hardest thing is when a weapon gets nerfed, because basically it just changes the entire weapon and it means relearning the weapon all over again. So in my opinion, there should only ever be buffs in the game. If a weapon is too strong, buff the rest of the weapons. Crysis 3 would be a pretty fun game around about this time if Crytek had stuck to that plan as well. It'd be crazy. So on to actually talking about my Grendel class here. I believe I've got a pretty strong loadout for it, combined with a pretty strong weapon in it. Kicks ass. So my 3 suit modules are Armor Transfer, Weapon Pro and Maneuverability, 3 of the best suit modules in the game in my opinion. Armor Transfer, Weapon Pro really helping you stay in the combat area, really helping you constantly engage those enemies. Basically you don't need to spend time hanging around waiting for your armor energy to recharge or wait for your weapon to reload. Weapon Pro also comes with that added benefit of really, really fast aim down sight weapon time, which really helps with pulling off them quick scopes. The Grendel also has really nice hip fire because it is a burst fire weapon. It does have less spread than your standard assault rifles. If enemies do get too close, the Grendel can deal with those guys pretty easily. One burst usually to the face, and then one melee to finish them off will help you out in those tight situations. A really good all-rounder weapon, can take on shotgunners, snipers, and other guys with rifles and submachine guns very easily. Also included in my Grendel class is the M12 Nova, my little beastin' pistol. It's a little beast, it's my favourite pistol in the game. I've also got flashbangs to make landing those shots a little bit easier sometimes as well. Up next is the infamous Scar Laser, and anyone who is a Crysis fan will know about Scar. Crysis 1, Crysis Wars, Crysis 2 and Crysis 3, Scar was always the most popular weapon, and this here is my preferred loadout for it in Crysis 3. The first thing to note on this class is that I am using a silencer on the Scar, which not too many people use in Crysis 3, and it really, really helps because of that fact. It just basically makes you invisible to enemies. You can walk onto a crash site, kill a bunch of guys, and then walk back off it. The guys, they just can't find you, especially if you throw in some stealth here and there, dodging in and out of cover, behind walls, flanking, and oh man, awesome. I love the silencer. The main aim of this class is basically to focus on hip firing only because of the recent patch by Crytek, Patch G. Aiming down sight with the Scar is really not that great at all. So hip fire only is the way to go basically with the Scar, blasting those guys to smithereens, spraying everywhere with as much precision as you possibly can manage. My suit modules for this class are Rapid Fire, Point Fire Enhance, and Maneuverability, again because Maneuverability is pretty much the all-rounder essential suit module in Crysis 3. Now the reason I've got Point Fire Enhance with the laser is basically because I want to have as less hip fire spread as possible. The silencer on my Scar increases spread, and Rapid Fire also greatly increases the spread of my weapon, so I need something else to counter these two things. Point Fire Enhance is there for that. I've tested it without Point Fire Enhance as well, and I performed much better with Point Fire Enhance on this hip fire only class. So you can try it out yourself, but with Point Fire Enhance you need to be a little bit more accurate with your hip firing. So if you're not too accurate at hip firing, maybe you might want to try a different suit module and see which one performs better for you. The silencer does decrease the overall range of the Scar, which means I have less damage at longer ranges, but I'm not too bothered about this because I will be hip firing only, and most of the time this is at close range. Combining close range hip fire silenced gameplay with rapid fire basically means I am outputting a hell of a lot of damage very quickly, and I'm moving very quickly and silently. Very effective class in my opinion. Up next we have the classic shotgun class, and when I say shotgun I mean Marshall. Marshall is the most awesome shotgun, and this is my preferred loadout for when I decide to run shotgun. So On this loadout, we are actually running the Naked Marshal with no attachments. None are required for this loadout. We've got three suit modules, which are Hunter, Maneuverability as usual, and Weapon Pro. It is a pump action shotgun, which means you're reloading one shot at a time, so Weapon Pro comes in handy there, helps you reload those one shots at a time a little bit faster. Shotgun does have two fire modes on it, which means you press 2 on your keyboard or something else if you're on console, and you can switch to the alternate fire mode of the Marshal. What the alternate fire mode of the Marshal does is basically just reduce the spread of the weapon. It fires a bunch of pellets, and so the second fire mode basically reduces the spread of those pellets, which really helps with targets which are a little bit further away from you, and for people who are a little bit more accurate in their shooting. The best way to go about utilizing the secondary fire mode is to stay in your longer range fire mode all the time. That's the one with less spread. And then once you engage an enemy, switch to your up close and personal one, which should help you out with getting enemies out of your base. I've got a rather underutilized suit module on this class, which is the Hunter suit module, which allows you to travel around the map silently and also allows you to hear enemies coming, track enemies really well through walls, anywhere you like, and as soon as they run around, you can just blast them in the face with your shotgun. Don't forget to equip your Jaw Rocket Launcher to your shotgun class, because that will help you take out those guys who are a bit further away and you still really like to kill them anyway. I've also got the AY69 machine pistol, just in case I blast someone, he runs away, I can just switch the pistol and spray him down. Onto our fourth custom class already, which is rightly named the Zapper, because we're going to be utilizing the Cable in this class. And you might think, oh, the Cable doesn't belong in this top 5 custom class video. Well, I honestly think it does. Cable has been getting buffed and buffed and buffed, while other weapons have been getting nerfed and nerfed and nerfed. So right about now, guys, Cable is a good weapon to use. The main advantage of the Cable is its blue electrostatic pellets, which when fired at an opponent's screen will completely distort it, cover it in blue electrical ripples and electrical lightning bolts. So that really gives you a good advantage over opponents, because if you can get the first shot off on them, it'll take them that little while longer to lock on target. They maybe might not know where you are, so they'll have to check their radar. One thing you need to know about the Cable before you use it is that its pellets do have slightly longer travel time than your standard bullets, which basically means you have to lead your shots. If an enemy is running across the map, you're going to have to be shooting slightly in front of him just to make sure your shots are landing. I am using rapid fire on this class to make sure I get a little bit more damage output from my Cable. I've also got extended mags to make sure that I do have enough bullets in my clip for taking on enemies. You don't need to reload all the time with the Cable. You can take on a few enemies before reloading. The Cable does have quite a sluggish reload, so I've got Weapon Pro on there as well to make sure my reloading is as fast as possible. Try it out, guys. Let me know in the comments below how you get on with the Cable. It is a really good class. I wouldn't be putting it up here if I didn't think it was. Just remember to try and get the first shot on your opponent, like I said earlier. Cable has also got really good hip fire as well, so you can strafe pretty well with close range targets, so try that out too. The final class for this video is going to be a class that I've only started using fairly recently. It is the Claw from the DLC, and I believe I found a pretty cool setup to use with it. For those of you out there who have used the Claw before, you're probably aware that it does have pretty high recoil. So basically what I'm using here is the Assault Scope, because it is the scope with the least recoil on the Claw. I also got the Muzzle Brake on there as well to reduce recoil further, and the Foregrip again to reduce the recoil or increase the stability of the weapon. My suit modules for this class are Point Fire Enhanced, Maneuverability and Proximity Alarm, basically because I'm going to be scoped in a lot of the time with the Assault Scope. Really reduces my field of view, my peripheral vision. I can't see guys coming from my left or right or behind, obviously, so Proximity Alarm is going to help me out there, and it'll let me know when an enemy is close. What it also does is it basically tells me when I should be hip firing with the Claw. I've got Point Fire Enhanced on here because the loadout sort of reminds me of an old favourite of mine from Crysis 2, which was the FY71 with Assault Scope and Point Fire Enhanced. I also had a silencer on that class, which unfortunately the Claw cannot equip a silencer, otherwise I would have it on here. Basically, with Point Fire Enhanced and Proximity Alarm, whenever my Proximity Alarm starts going crazy, the game is practically telling me that I should be hip firing right about now, so when my Proximity Alarm goes off, I start hip firing, and it works pretty effectively. It's a nice little signal for me. The footsteps in Crysis 3 aren't very loud, so I like this way, it works pretty good. The Claw does have a pretty large magazine as well, so you shouldn't be needing to reload very often. The bullets do quite a lot of damage, you'll be able to kill quite a few enemies before needing to reload. I've also got the Majestic on this class because with Point Fire Enhanced, the Majestic is an absolute beast. You just run around hip firing people with this revolver. Really pretty awesome. So check out the Majestic with Point Fire Enhance as well, guys. And that's it. That's my tips for the top 5 custom classes in Crysis 3, guys. The top 5 most fun classes as well. Just making sure you got that part. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please check out some of my other videos as well. Hope you enjoyed this. Please leave a comment, leave a rating, whatever you like. Thanks, guys. See you later.